Okay, all of you. Today, now I'm going to explain about disadvantage of free trade through this video. Yesterday, in our previous, video class, I've already explained about, free trade. And on your class also, I'll explain about the advantage of free trade. So today, I'm going to explain you about disadvantage of free trade. Now, there are many disadvantages of free trade. So here I have mentioned only 5 points, which I am going to explain today. Now, number one is exhaustion of natural resources. Now, exhaustion of natural resources means, now when this free trade especially happens, the natural resources of developing countries are utilized by developed countries in the form of raw materials. Because all the developing countries, what they have, they are not so well industrialized, so they don't have, many of industries, so not of the, natural resources, they will remain unused. So in such cases, what the developing country, they do that. So what the developed country, they do that, they, take away the resources of developing countries in the form of minerals. So when they take away the natural resources of developing country in the form of minerals, so in the form of raw materials, they take in very low price. They take in very what? Low price. But same, natural resources, when they will take in their own country, and after that, with the help of that raw material, when they will manufacture some, final goods and products, what means? Again, they will send such goods or final product to the developing countries in high price. So what means? The developing countries, they are forced to sell their raw materials in low price, and they are forced to buy the product of developed country in high price. So in this sense, the natural resources of developing countries are exhausted. Means they are what? Not well utilized. They are what? overtaken by this what? Developed countries. Now, adverse effect on domestic industries. Now it says that easily what means developing countries, when you talk about developing countries, developed countries are not well industrialized due to lack of, proper, manpower, due to lack of advanced technology, due to lack of capitals. So it means in developing country, if there are some industries and factories which are established, they are also not so well, advanced. They are also not so, developed. They are still in infant stage. They are still in growing stage. So what means? Such industry and factory also, they are forced to have a combination with the industry of developed country, which are already developed, which are already mature, which are already, mature. So in such cases, what happens? The domestic industry will not be able to compare with the products of developed countries. So in that cases, what happens? The domestic product will be, affected. For example, if any good and service which are produced by Nepal, and if same type of good and service which are produced by America, if American goods comes in Nepali market, for advance, definitely advance, if you see the, quality of goods will be very different. The quality of goods will be far better than, far better of American goods in compared to Nepali goods. So definitely advance, and the customer, they will prefer to buy the American product, not the Nepali product. So in that case, what means? The Nepali product or the Nepali industry will suffer. So in this advance, it said that due to this treated advance, this adverse effect on domestic industry also. Now economic dependency means it is said that when there is free trade policy, what the developing country they do that, they will try to, produce only those goods and services which are produced in very, least price, which has very personal cost low. And they will not try to do investment on such industrial factory where production cost is very high. Then what happens? They will try to import all those goods from developed countries. So when they will try to import all those goods from developed countries, what happens? Along with that goods, they will also have to sometime, demand for some cash also, take some loan, some donations. So such cases occur in developing countries. Because such country, when they will take away our raw materials and with their raw materials, you know, they will produce final goods and services, and they will sell that goods and services to Nepali peoples or to the Nepal country. What means? There's a lot of, you know, economic activities, and they'll have a lot of profit, but Nepal will not be able to earn any profit. Moreover, what means? They have to import the goods from other country, and high amount of, you know, capital will outflow. A lot of money will go other country, and day by day the country will be economically poor. So when the country will be economically poor, when the country will not be able to, you know, balance its budget also, what happens? At the time, how can one country absolutely depend on other country? The dependency, our economic dependency will be greater and greater day by day. So that's what happens due to a free trade, there is also economic dependency. Now, import of harmful goods. Now, it says that when there is free trade policy, it says that there is no restriction in importing and exporting any goods. All the goods and services are imported without any restriction. So, what means? Sometimes, due to no any restrictions, what happens? Those goods which are harmful, those goods which can affect the health of the people, such goods also may enter. Like talking about limit our drugs, when people consume that drug, that will affect the health of the people. So such type of drug also may come. Or like weapons, which are very dangerous, you know, which will, you know, which will import, which will, you know, improve what criminal activity in the nations, which will improve the number of criminals. Such, you know, weapon also may enter, because if they split it, the weapon, when they enter, everyone else will use their weapons, criminals, you know. So criminal activity will also increase. So this happens. It is said that due to free trade policy, sometimes happens. Even ample goods also may enter. Now, reduction in saving and investment. They said that due to free trade policy, what happens? Even what happens? Developing country or even poor country, what happens? They are forced to import goods from other country. Because when there is free trade policy, even what happens? Developing country, if they are not produce any goods in their own country, they will import from other country. So when they will import from other country, what happens? The people will become habituated regarding, you know, consuming the foreign goods. Although they are poor, but they have become habituated to buy such goods, you know. And what happens? So what means? People income will be, or the people saving and investment will be decreased day by day. Because when the goods are entered in one country, what means? They will buy. People will be habituated to buy, you know, luxurious goods, you know. People may be habituated to buy those goods which are unnecessary. And when they will invest on such goods, what means? Their saving will be less, and there will be no saving, and there will be no what? Investment in the nations. There will be no capital formation in the nations. So today in this video, I have explained about what? Disadvantages of free trade. Okay, thank you all of you.